Lynn from WisconsinGarden.net. Today I'm going to be talking to you about something that we're having fun with right now, and a lot of it has to do with our dear neighbor Ginger, who got us all excited about hummingbirds and how to get them to your house. She's been seeing them now for weeks, and we were even playing with them yesterday at her house, and she gave us some suggestions about how we could get more to come to our house. One of her suggestions was to decorate around your hummingbird feeder with bright flowers. Flowers the color that they like that will attract them to your feeder. So my dear husband went to the dollar store yesterday and came home with a variety of imitation flowers. They don't have to be real ones because that would just be way too expensive. Got a variety of the colors they like, lots of reds and purples and some oranges and yellows. What I did first this morning was I chose a bunch of flowers with lots of color, and then they really like reds and pinks and purples, so I think I'm going to go with these two together. And I'm using black electrical tape. You could use any kind of plastic tape that'll last outside in the rain. And this is my Shepard's hook, where I will have two or maybe just one hummingbird feeder on here. And I want to make this look attractive to a hummingbird. So I'm just going to take that. I'm going to cut off a piece of my electrical tape. At first I thought I could just take these and wrap them around, bend them around, but my goodness, they use hard wire inside those little things. So I found that electrical tape will work good. Put it up here so that they can readily see them. Tape it on. Be careful because some of them have little pokey things on them too, which I found right there. Okay, so that's my basis. And in real life, flowers don't grow like that, so I bent a few over to make it look a little more natural. Keeping in mind my feeder will be over here. Okay, so now I've got my base, but now I don't just want those two, I want a variety of colors. So I'll go back and I've taken smaller ones. I've taken like this yellow one. Using a very strong scissors or a wire cutter on a pliers, I cut off something of a different color. I'll push that up there. And maybe I'll take an orange one. So you can modify these however you want. I'm just trying to get as many likable things as possible. Get my tape again. It is hard to find the end of that tape. Oh, here it is. And I'm going to just add some color. And I'm going to put some on the back side too, because it's not just one-dimensional. Flowers grow in all directions, so.
And the hummingbirds are coming from all directions, too.
That's so. Right. They're not just going to see it from the front or whatever you consider the front to be. And again, I'm going to bend them out a little bit so they... Now, obviously hummingbirds don't have a brain that realizes that flowers would not grow 5 feet off the ground with a black stem. Thank goodness. So what do you think, Rick? Think I need more color, or do you think that'll do?
No, just spread them out a little bit more.
Okay.
I figure you have, I think, 7 or 8 shepherd hooks now that you're going to be decorating. And where did you get these shepherd hooks?
These?
Mm-hmm.
These I got at Aldi's for $8. That's unbelievable. That's an unbelievable price. Get over there if you've got an Aldi's and you want a shepherd's hook. It's a great deal, and they didn't get a whole lot of them, she said. Now I'm just going to put a couple more pieces of tape around edges that are just sticking out that I, yep, I think I'll put one down there too. Now, keep in mind that come winter, and the birds are gone, and the flowers are gone, and it's snowy out, you can still have flowers.
Fake your neighbors out, right?
That's right. There we go.
Boy, you're going to have some jealous neighbors this winter.
There we go. Okay, the birds will love it once their food gets hanging there.
And what are you going to do for hummingbird feeders?
Now, for feeders, you can buy them practically anywhere, in any garden store or bird store. You can also make them. You can take a red, it has to be red, they really like red, tall Dixie cup, cut two little holes in the sides so they can stick their beak in, put some little holes up at the top with a piece of yarn, and fill it up with sugar water. One part sugar, four parts water. Mix it up really well and pour it in.
In fact, you have one outside. Why don't we go out there and show?
Okay. This is what I mean, a red cup, cut a little square in there so the hummingbird can stick their little beak in there. Take a little pen or something sharp that'll get through there just to make a piece of, take a piece of yarn and hang it up there. Now this is a perfect situation. There's lots of flowers around, but they're not blooming yet. And a hummingbird is not going to be attracted back here until something is blooming. So in the meanwhile, you can attract them using your flowers from the dollar store and a nice tall pole that will keep it safe from cats and squirrels and things. So bye for now. Enjoy. I hope you get some.